Okay, my screen is visible. That called. Okay. Didu a lekol. Where is Didu? The sentence means is Didu is at the school. Afifa, you can write it down. Prabhnoor has already written. Didu is the name of the mouse. So Didu. A means at. A lekol. Didu is at the school. Prabhnoor, start reading from here where my arrow is. Prasanthe, Prabhnoor, Prasanthe, it's the same pronunciation, okay? Sir Prasanthe. Sir Prasanthe means present yourself. Yes, Afifa. Yeah, I have written the translation so that you can write it down. This is for you only. Okay, Prabhnoor, continue. Lekol, Alsacien. Racine, of the Cartien Latin. Okay, so let us visit a school in Paris. The name of the school is L'Ecole Alsacienne, and where is it? It is on Rue Racine. The meaning of Rue is street. It is on the street Racine of the Quartier Latin. It's a place given. Okay, Afifa, start reading from here. Bonjour. The En, bonjour, je m'appelle Didu, j'ai 2 ans. J'ai un frère. It says, bonjour, je m'appelle Didu, j'ai 2 ans, j'habite à Paris, j'ai un frère. Hello, my name is Didu, I am 2 years old, j'habite à Paris means I live in Paris. Yes, you should. J'ai un frère, I have a brother. Yes, Prabhnoor, I know. Then don't write it again. Okay, then, okay, Afifa, quickly. Okay, then the person asked, "Comment tu t'appelles?" Comment tu t'appelles means what is your name? Repeat after me one by one. Prabhul, first you repeat, "Comment tu t'appelles?" Afifa, repeat. Okay, now repeat, "Quel âge as-tu?" This means what is your age? Okay, next, Prabhu, repeat, "Où habites-tu?" Okay, correct, Afifa. Okay, we guys already know how to answer to this question. When someone says, "Comment tu t'appelles?" How do we reply? When someone asks, "What is your name?" in French, "Comment tu t'appelles?" How will we reply? Prabnur? Je m'appelle, correct. Okay, this is what we use to answer to our to name. When someone says, "Kela jati ho?" So how will I reply? What is my age? How will I say? Prabnur, how do you tell your age? J, ha. So we say J dash on B, whatever our age is. Okay. How do we tell where do I live? Shabit. Ah, then wherever we. Ha, correct. Oh, what did I put? So wherever we live, we put that here. Okay, so we know how to answer this question. It's just the pronunciation. Okay, Afifa, how will you ask what is your name? It's written here. I'm just asking you to read. Comment tu t'appelles? Prabhur, how will I ask what is your age? Quel âge as-tu? Afifa, how will I ask where do you live? How will I ask? How will I ask, not respond? Où habites-tu? Okay. Et vous, monsieur means, Prabnur, we did not write anything after this, so you will also write, okay? I'm saying we did in the last class, we did only till that second bubble. No, we did not do this bubble. So from this, you will also write everything. Acha, okay. If you guys see here, everything was tu t'appelles, kelaj a tu, u abit tu. Now, in the third bubble, everything is vous. Comment vous appelez-vous? Quel âge avez-vous? Où habitez-vous? Everything is vous. Now, what is the difference between comment tu t'appelles and comment vous appelez-vous? When we talk to our friends, we can use tu. Okay, it is informal. But when I am talking to my teacher, I cannot ask my teacher comment tu t'appelles. To my teacher, I will ask comment vous appelez-vous. So vous, vous, we use this for formal conversations. Okay. Do you both like you guys understood the meaning of formal? With what I mean formal here, formal means talking to someone elder, talking to our teachers, talking to someone we meet for the first time. Ha, correct. Talking to parents, grandparents, someone elder. Okay, so we will use vous. Okay, the meaning remains same. Comment vous appelez-vous means. Ha, correct. Comment allez-vous is also formal, okay? I will not ask my friend comment allez-vous. To my friend I will say ça va, but to elders I will always keep it formal. I will say comment allez-vous. So now what is the meaning? Como vos apele mu means what is your name? Kela jave mu means what is your age? U habite vu means what is where do you live? The meaning remains same. What they were in the second bubble, it's same here. The difference is this you will use with elder people and formal conversations. Yes, Prabhnoor? What is your name? Okay. No, don't write. Just write this. That who we use for formal conversations. Basically, we use it for with elder people. We use it with elder people, teachers. And plural. Okay, for example, I want to ask Prabhnoor's name, okay? So I will say como tu tapel. But I want to know the name of both Prabhnoor and Afifa. So my question will be como vos apelevo, because you are two people, okay? You are not singular, you are plural, right? Both of you, if I'm talking about two people. Yes, no? Oi, so when there are two people, then when there are more than one person, basically, when it's plural, then also we use vu. Okay? Okay. D'accord. Okay, write this down, this point, then we'll go to the next bubble. Okay. Prabhnoor written. D'accord. Okay. Now we'll go to the next bubble. Achha, before we go to the next bubble, just write. IEL means he and ELL means she. So whenever there is he, she. Yes, Prabhnoor. IEL is ill, ELLE is L. ILL. Okay. Okay, now Didu is introducing us to a boy. Il s'appel Eric. What is his name? The name of the boy is? It's written C, Eric. Eric. So he. Il a nav on. He is how much years old? Correct. Il abit. Yes, Afifa. I did not understand it. Voi. Il abit riu du Cartien Latin a Pari. Where does he live? He lives in the Strait of Cartien Latin a Pari. So now, till now, you both knew that how will I say my name is. I will say my name is as Jamapel. But when I have to say his name is, so I will say il s'appel. When I have to say his name, I will say il s'appel. Okay? Il s'appel, then whatever the name of the person is. When I have to say I have, so I say je uito. For example, Prabhnoor says. So for example, then Eric il a nav on. He has 9 years. This means he is 9 years old. I एंड एलाबीत मीन्स ही लिव्स. Okay, next bubble. Now it is L. What did I tell? What is the meaning of L? L means she. So L spells Sophie. She is Sophie. Okay, what is the name of the Didu's friend? Her name is Sophie. How many years old she is? Correct. She is 7 years old. And where is she? Where she lives? She lives at the Rue Jean Mega Paris. Elabit means she lives. Okay. Okay. Write this down. Okay. Now close your books. Close your books. Okay, now I will write something on my screen. You will not write anything. You will not write anything. You will only listen and understand. Okay, whatever I explain. D'accord. Or both of you can see my screen. FIFA. Is it blur? FIFA, it might be the internet. Maybe. Okay. This is Prabhnoor, okay? Matlab, this is not Prabhnoor, I am drawing a figure of Prabhnoor. Okay, and this is Afifa, okay? Okay, this is Prabhnoor and this is Afifa. Achha, Prabhnoor and Afifa, when you will talk about yourself, which pronoun do we use? How do we say my name is? Okay, so which pronoun are we using? We are using je, pronoun, I, okay, je. Okay, now Prabhnoor wants to talk to Afifa and Afifa wants to talk to Prabhnoor. You will still say I or you will say which pronoun in English? How will I talk to someone else? We will say you, right? Yes, oi. Okay, so how do we ask what is your name, Prabhnoor and Afifa in French? Comment? Name. Comment tu t'appelles? So we have tu. Tu means you. When we are saying je m'appelle, it means me. When I say comment tu, tu means you. Now, Afifa wants to know about Prabhnoor's friend's name. Okay, so we don't know na name. So we will say il or el, like I told you. He or she, right? So il is he, el is she. Okay, repeat after me. Je. Tu. Tu, il, elle. Okay, these are these all are singular pronouns, okay? Because we are talking about one person only, right? Now we will talk about plural pronouns. Achha, now I am also introduced, okay? Now I am also here. Okay, now this is me. Now I want to tell something about all three of us. In English, if I say we, okay, we should learn French, for example, all three of us. So we say as, repeat after me, nous. Okay, now I want to talk to both of you. So it means I'm talking to how many people? Two people, right? So the singular you. When I'm talking to one person only, I can use tu. But when I'm talking to two people, I will use... This is plural you. When then vous. We just did know, comment vous appelez-vous, right? So, till now we have six pronouns. Now I want to know the name of Afifa's school friends. So I will I say he, she, or will I say they, because they are plural? What will I use? They, right? So it is ils, say il, l. Okay, now see, both of them means they. But when we are talking about a lot of boys, we use ils, that is masculine, okay? And when I'm talking about a lot of girls, I will say l. Now you will say, ma'am, why are you not saying ills, ls? Because there is s, right? There is s, right? It should be ills, ls, according to, if we see, no. The pronunciation is ill, l only. The pronunciation is ill, l here. The pronunciation is ill, l here. Okay, so the pronunciation is going to be ill, l only. Be it il, be it ils, be it elle, be it elles. Okay? Okay, not okay. Rabnoor, Afifa, reply. D'accord. Okay, now I'm going to do again. I'm just writing all of these again. Je means I. Tu means you. Il means he. Elle also means. Il means he. Elle means she. Nous means we. Vous means you. And il means they. But masculine when there are all boys. And elle when there are all girls. In plural, we add s to it, okay? But the pronunciation remains same. I will not say ills, ls. I will say ill, l only. You have to understand, tu also means you, vous also means you. This you will use with singular when there is only one person. This you will use with plural when there are a lot of people, okay? Ça va? D'accord? Okay, and this we will use with informal. With informal, I mean you can use with your friends, your cousins, your brother, sister. But this you will use with formal, like your parents, your grandparents, your teachers. Okay, with teachers, you cannot say tu. To teachers, you will always say vous. To your parents, you will not say tu. To your parents, you will say vous. D'accord? You understanding or no? D'accord. Okay. D'accord. Okay. Now take out your notebooks and write this down. I'll zoom it. First write this much down, then I'll scroll it. if you want. Okay, just one thing I forgot. We call this, the heading of the topic is subject pronouns. Why do we call it subject pronouns? Because we always start the sentence with these pronouns. Okay, so this is the heading. First write this down, then I'll scroll up. Okay, now getting back to the book, open lesson through again. Throwa, lesson 3. Or you can just see my screen also. You can skip it because I'm not going. You guys don't have to write anything. Okay, it says that here it is again showing. When it's I, we use je. When it's you, we use tu. When it's he, we use il. When it's L, we use she. When it's L, then nu is we. There are a lot of people. Now vu is you all. When we are talking to more than one person. L, C. Now you will see feminine. There are girls in plural form. And here we have boys in plural form. Okay? Okay? D'accord. So that's it from this, like this. And your homework is you will learn this table. Like this is the notes that we wrote. You can learn from here as well. You can learn from the book as well. Or like the notes we wrote. You have to learn that je means I, tu means you, ilel means he, she, nu means wo. You have to learn this, the whole table, pronos, usage. This is the topic we wrote, no? Subject, pronoun. So this is, you will learn. No. Only the subject pronouns. Just a second, wait.